The deceased were identified as Taremwa Aloysius, who was operating the canoe, and others were Timothy Kakuru and Amuntuhaiwe Rukundo. Taremwa Aloysius had operated the canoe on the river for a number of years. A number of residents camped in hope of recovering bodies of their loved ones. Local self-trained drivers were hired by the relatives of the deceased in search for the bodies. The families of the deceased were also left grief-stricken.
To make every effort to make sure that at least they solicit funds and put a temporary bridge for pedestrians and borders so that people can cross, as we wait for government to do what? To do the other great work it has always promised.
They should streamline the bridges which people should use, and the government should enforce, make sure that people use the bridges which are gazetted. And maybe another thing, like this boat, I doubt whether it was an authorized boat to transport people.
Right now, we don't know who is going to be next. Because people must move, people must go for service delivery in town. Okay? People want to access services. But as I talk, the cost of meeting the daily transaction is becoming too much. That's why we find someone wants to cross. They are about even to fly if they could fly.
Meanwhile, the Uganda National Roads Authority has expressed worry that the ongoing construction works at Kabarechisoro Road that was recently damaged by landslides might be hindered due to traffic.
The surface is
failing. We issued an announcement on the diversion routes last week on May 4th. We announced the diversions for all nature of traffic at the moment. This is so that we can be allowed time to expedite the works. But also it is unsafe because it is a construction site, so we don't want to expose motorists to danger.
The UNRIA initially released a statement advising motorists to use alternative routes. However, after Minister Ichweru orders to open the road, motorists abandoned the alternative routes that had been suggested by UNRA and embarked on reusing the road that is currently under rehabilitation. Alan Sempewa, the UNRA spokesperson, has explained the need for drivers to use alternative routes.
To open up this section to traffic, I cannot set out a stage because our teams are actually working. They are working. We've actually not set out stages for within which we should actually work. For us, we are actually on ground to restore this section as quickly as possible. Now, that will go on well if we don't have interruptions in case of traffic continuing to use the road, but also weather.
I want to tell you the truth, that alternative routes are not manageable. They are also part of the disaster. The alternative routes also got spoiled. So what I would request them to do is that now that they are thinking of the alternative routes in this period of time, they should maintain the one of Kagarama up to Nyaruhanga. If they can push their graders to do some bit of maintenance there, the small vehicles, the average vehicles, the double cabins and the small ones can use that route. But the trailers cannot go through those routes because of the sharp corners and the steep slopes.
Chigezi sub-region is among the areas that were badly affected by the recent landslides and floods following the heavy rains at the start of the month. About 20 people lost their lives and most roads were impassable. Report by Abdul Karim Sengendo and Job Namanya for the news.